Hey, what's up, everybody? Xul's Extreme here, and if you've been following the news, there was a F-35B that went down around the Beaufort area of South Carolina, where the Marine base is. So I was thinking that we'll go ahead and fly one of the F-35B 501s around the area and see what some of the logistical problems would be with spotting that aircraft from the air, since it's finally been found. They found a debris field. So they're assuming it's the aircraft. So let's go ahead and jump into the game. As you can see, we'll fly around the perimeter of the airport, and we'll be in one of the 501 F-35 that actually fly out of there. And so we should be able to look around and see if we can find anything on the ground. Of course, it's not going to be in the game, but we can use our imagination as to if it would be easy to locate the plane, because it doesn't sound like it was easy. I'm thinking that if it disintegrated when it crashed, it probably made it a lot harder to find it, obviously. So that could be one of the issues. It is sort of weird, though, to lose an aircraft, especially one that's the most modern, technologically built one ever. So that is a concern. But there's probably a logical explanation for it that has nothing to do with presidents or politics or anything. So here we are at Beaufort. As you can see, the airfield, the Marine airfield base here, and there is our beautiful F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. So we're from the VMF AT-501. I believe that's one of the Striker squadrons stationed here, and it looks like we're doing a cold start. I didn't really anticipate that. Okay, let's see, you gotta turn on the battery. Where is it? It's been a while since I've done the cold start, sorry. There's the master arm switch, which is not really. You can't see. Boom. Turn on inverters and converters. Not making it easy with head tracking either. Master ignition switch has got to be on. There we go. Pull that back. Our battery switch is not on yet, which sucks. There we go. So we'll start booting up the computers. Of course, we can pull our pins and arm the ejection seat. Close the canopy. I honestly wasn't planning to do a cold start. It was just going to kind of jump in so we could fly, but whatever. It doesn't take that long to start an F-35, so. And we'll go ahead and go to start. A second while the computers and everything boot up. What's things going on here? Flight control system, SMS. Let's change this one. Where's the map one? Checklist. Hover. Like so, and we can get an outside view of the plane as well here. As we can see, we are fully pins are pulled, everything's ready to go, it looks like. So we'll go ahead and put it in full hover. Oops. Wrong button. There we go. Yes, that's the hover takeoff right there. Let's jump back in the cockpit here. So with Microsoft Flight Simulator, it uses Microsoft Maps. So it's kind of going to be whatever Microsoft Maps gives us, which is actually pretty decent. And I am running a 3090 RTX right now, so it's should look pretty good. And I have the settings on. So go ahead and fly around and see what we can find here. Let's turn on a little map here. There we go. There's an overhead map so we can see where we're heading. And like I said, we'll just kind of do a perimeter around the base and just kind of view the landscape that we have to see why it would be hard to find this jet. And I'm thinking with the trees right now, I can see exactly why it would be hard, because it's not like the area around my house where it's wide open fields and you'd be able to see a jet down easily. So let's go ahead and take it out of hover, give her some gas, pull up the landing gear. Oh yeah, this would be really hard terrain to find a plane in. And especially if it went into one of these little lakes or something like that, you know. So it said it was about 2 miles out was where they're finding debris, so it wasn't that far from the field. I mean, yeah, logistically speaking, I could see right away why it would be hard to find this plane. It's not even the terrain, it's all flat. It's just... You know, the other thing that I did note is what the articles have said about it is that there was a wingman with him too, so I'm surprised that the wingman wouldn't have, like, tracked the plane. Maybe he tracked the parachute. Would be the explanation for that, which would make sense. I mean, your first concern would be the safety of the pilot, not the jet, so. And as far as I know, the pilot is in stable condition. When you eject, I mean, you basically you could break your neck, your back. There's there's a lot of things that happen when you use the ejection seats, so. We got some altitude here too. So yeah, I think it would be pretty tough to find the plane if it landed in any of the areas that aren't inhabited. I mean, obviously if it went into a neighborhood, we'd know where it went, which would have been way worse. So it's kind of nice that it would happen. As a training exercise, things will happen. Planes go down all the time. I mean, just like with the Reno Air Show, you know, we had another crash there on Sunday, which was pretty devastating. So it's not unheard of for planes to crash. Yeah, thank God it didn't go into one of these neighborhoods, you know. That could have been devastating. But all these little lakes around here and stuff, and these rivers and everything, if it had gone into any of those, that would have been worse. I'm not exactly sure where the debris field was found, because they didn't really note it in any of the articles that I've read, so. But it did. The one article that I did read that was in the AP that said it was 2 miles away from the base. So. Yeah, there is a lot of, you know, residential buildings and stuff around here, so it, I mean, I know it sounds stupid that it got lost and stuff, but man, we can count our blessings. The pilot is safe, and it, you know, and everybody on the ground is safe, so I'm pretty happy with the outcome. I'm not gonna blame anybody. Yeah, it sucks to lose a plane, definitely, but you know what? Everybody's okay. It must be the scariest thing, dude. I mean, you know you're gonna have to eject, the plane's having an issue. I can't imagine. And that's a stall warning because I'm going slow. I mean, there's a number of little, you know, rivers and lakes and streams and stuff that thing could have easily gone into. And then just a ton of, like, woodland, too. Mixed with a bunch of housing. So, yeah. It's a cool area, man. South Carolina's nice, actually. I mean, you can get fireworks. My favorite thing was about South Carolina. South of the border, baby. They got those signs all the way up in Maryland. Yep. Crazy that if it hit the ground it wouldn't have caught on fire, but I mean, I guess you never know. It was in, they said it was in autopilot and it was in stealth, so, which I wasn't aware that there was an actual button for stealth mode. I just thought it was dependent on what your armament was. Like, say if you had a bunch of missiles on your wing, you're not going to be stealth anymore, but if they're hidden inside the belly, then yeah, I don't know. It's kind of a crazy thing. And you know, with the F-35B it can go into hover too, so the wingman could have gone into hover and sat there and watched the whole thing basically. I'm not sure. Yeah, I guess it would depend what velocity he was going and stuff at the time, because you can't just go into hover when you're over, you know, 250. It basically wouldn't go into hover. Like, we did hover right now, you can see we're still in fly, and we'd have to slow down a bit before we actually go into hover. And once we did go into hover, it'll straighten out the aircraft and we'll actually go into the hover. So we have hover enabled right now and we're still sort of flying. If we put the speed brake on, we'll slow down. There you go. So that's hover. And that's letting me know that the gears aren't down. I'm going to put the gear down right there. Because when you're going to hover, I guess the plane assumes it's going to land. Or when you go into short takeoff and landing, basically, the start of it. If you go into hover, the full on hover like this, if you push the hover button here, you go into a full hover. So you're just suspended. And in the other mode, you can move. So you can go forward and backwards. But you can definitely see why it would be hard to recover this plane. So, even I've seen a lot of weird comments, obviously. Sometimes I get roped into reading the comments and I'm just like, oh my god, come on guys. Accidents happen. Right in front of us again. So we'll make our way back there and do a nice little landing. So we did fly around about 2 miles out around the entire base. As you can see, there would be a lot of room for a plane to go down, and would be pretty, especially if it exploded into a bunch of pieces and you didn't see the original explosion, it might be hard to find. I know South Carolina, it's more humid and it's a little bit more wet too, so it's probably not going to start a fire on the ground like it would where I live in California. If the plane went down, it would probably catch the whole field on fire. everything's so dry. Golden State here. Of course, this plane is incredibly easy to land. If you are interested in checking this plane out, this is the India Fox Techno F-35, and I would love to see this in DCS. Can we get this in DCS, please? Just like that, we have landed. Take our parking brake off here. Little trick: if you land in hover with your parking brake on, you won't roll. So that's a little trick. If you're trying to land on a cool landing pad somewhere in the game. So that was the video. We just flew around the base here, looking to see if we could find. Or not find it, but looking, you know, why it would be hard to find the F-35B that disappeared the other day, and I guess they did finally find the debris field, which they believe is the plane, so, yep. If you have any questions or comments, leave them, and, yeah, thanks for checking this out. It's always fun flying the F-35. It's pretty much my favorite plane, next to the F-22. Those are both my favorite planes in Microsoft Flight Simulator, because I'm more of like a jet, fighter jet type pilot than I am a commercial pilot, but I still like flying everything. It's just so much nicer to be able to go faster and get across the map quicker to see stuff. So anyways, thanks for checking this video out, and as always, peace out, Exulus Extreme. What's up, everybody? Zool's Extreme here. And following the news, there was an F-35B that went down around the Beaufort in South Carolina, where the Marine base is. So I was thinking that we'll go ahead and fly one of the F-35B-501s around the area and see what some of the logistical problems would be with spotting that aircraft from the air, since it's finally been found. They found a debris field, so they're assuming it's the aircraft. So let's go ahead and jump into the game. As you can see, we'll fly around the perimeter of the airport, and we'll be in one of the 501 F-35 that actually fly out of there. And so we should be able to look around and see if we can find anything on the ground. Of course, it's not going to be in the game, but we can use our imagination as to if it would be easy to locate the plane, because it doesn't sound like it was easy. I'm thinking that if it disintegrated when it crashed, it probably made it a lot harder to find it, obviously. So that could be one of the issues. It is sort of weird, though, to lose an aircraft, especially one that's the most modern, technologically built one ever. So that is a concern. But there's probably a logical explanation for it that has nothing to do with presidents or politics or anything. So here we are at Beaufort. As you can see, the airfield, the Marine Airfield base here, and there is our beautiful F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. So we're from the VMF AT-501. I believe that's one of the Striker squadron stationed here, and it looks like we're doing a cold start. I didn't really anticipate that. Okay, let's see, you gotta turn on the battery. Where is it? It's been a while since I've done the cold start, sorry. There's the master arm switch, which is not really. Okay, let's see. Boom. Turn on inverters and converters. Not making it easy with head tracking either. Master ignition switch has got to be on. There we go. Pull that back. Our battery switch is not on yet, which sucks. There we go. So we'll start booting up the computers. So we can pull our pins and arm the ejection seat. Close the canopy. I honestly wasn't planning to do a cold start. I was just going to kind of jump in so we could fly, but whatever. It doesn't take that long to start an F-35, so. And we'll go ahead and go to start. Second, while the computers and everything boot up. Lots of things going on here. Flight control system, SMS. Let's change this one. Where's the map one? Checklist. Hover. I like so, and we can get an outside view of the plane as well here. As you can see, we are fully pins are pulled, everything's ready to go, it looks like. So we'll go ahead and put it in full hover. Oops. Wrong button. There we go. Yes, that's the hover takeoff right there. Let's jump back in the cockpit here. So with Microsoft Flight Simulator, it uses Microsoft Maps. So it's kind of going to be whatever Microsoft Maps gives us, which is actually pretty decent. And I am running a 3090 RTX right now, so it's should look pretty good. And I have the settings on. So go ahead and fly around and see what we can find here. Let's turn on a little map here. There we go. There's an overhead map so we can see where we're heading. And like I said, we'll just kind of do a perimeter around the base and just kind of view the landscape that we have to see why it would be hard to find this jet. And I'm thinking with the trees right now, I can see exactly why it would be hard, because it's not like the area around my house where it's wide open fields and you'd be able to see a jet down easily. So let's go ahead and take it out of hover, give her some gas, pull up the landing gear. Oh yeah, this would be really hard terrain to find a plane in. And especially if it went into one of these little lakes or something like that, you know. So it said it was about 2 miles out was where they're finding debris, so it wasn't that far from the field. I mean, yeah, logistically speaking, I could see right away why it would be hard to find this plane. It's not even the terrain, it's all flat. It's just. You know, the other thing that I did note is what the articles have said about it is that there was a wingman with him too, so I'm surprised that the wingman wouldn't have, like, tracked the plane. Maybe he tracked the parachute. Would be the explanation for that, which would make sense. I mean, your first concern would be the safety of the pilot, not the jet, so. And as far as I know, the pilot is in stable condition. When you eject, I mean, you basically you could break your neck, your back. There's there's a lot of things that happen when you use the ejection seats, so. We've got some altitude here too. So yeah, I think it would be pretty tough to find the plane if it landed in any of the areas that aren't inhabited. I mean, obviously if it went into a neighborhood, we'd know where it went, which would have been way worse. So it's kind of nice that it would happen. As a training exercise, things will happen. Planes go down all the time. I mean, just like with the Reno Air Show, you know, we had another crash there on Sunday, which was pretty devastating. So it's not unheard of for planes to crash. Man, thank God it didn't go into one of these neighborhoods, you know. That could have been devastating. But all these little lakes around here and stuff, and these rivers and everything, if it had gone into any of those, that would have been worse. I'm not exactly sure where the debris field was found, because they didn't really note it in any of the articles that I've read, so. But it did, the one article that I did read that was in the AP that said it was 2 miles away from the base. So. Yeah, there is a lot of, you know, residential buildings and stuff around here. So I know it sounds stupid that it got lost and stuff, but man, we can count our blessings. The pilot is safe, and it, you know, and everybody on the ground is safe. So I'm pretty happy with the outcome. I'm not gonna blame anybody. Yeah, it sucks to lose a plane, definitely, but you know what? Everybody's okay. It must be the scariest thing, dude. I mean, you know you're gonna have to eject. The plane's having an issue. I can't imagine. And that's a stall warning because I'm going slow. I mean, there's a number of little, you know, rivers and lakes and streams and stuff that thing could have easily gone into. And then just a ton of, like, woodland, too. Mixed with a bunch of housing. So, yeah. It's a cool area, man. South Carolina's nice, actually. Well, you can get fireworks. You tell me my favorite thing was about South Carolina. South of the border, baby. They got those signs all the way up in Maryland. Yep. Crazy that if it hit the ground it wouldn't have caught on fire, but I mean, I guess you never know. It was in, they said it was an autopilot and it was in stealth, so, which I wasn't aware that there was an actual button for stealth mode. I just thought it was dependent on what your armament was. Like, say if you had a bunch of missiles on your wing, you're not going to be stealth anymore, but if they're hidden inside the belly, then yeah, I don't know. It's kind of a crazy thing. And you know, with the F-35B it can go into hover too, so the wingman could have gone into hover and sat there and watched the whole thing basically. I'm not sure. Yeah, I guess it would depend what velocity he was going and stuff at the time, because you can't just go into hover when you're over, you know, 250. It basically wouldn't go into hover. Like, we did hover right now, you can see we're still in fly, and we'd have to slow down a bit before we actually go into hover. And once we did go into hover, it'll straighten out the aircraft and we'll actually go into the hover. So we have hover enabled right now and we're still sort of flying. If we put the speed brake on, we'll slow down. There you go. So that's hover. And that's letting me know that the gears aren't down. I'm going to put the gear down right there. Because when you're going to hover, I guess the plane assumes it's going to land. Or when you go into short takeoff and landing, basically, the start of it. If you go into hover, the full on hover like this, if you push the hover button here, you go into a full hover, so you're just suspended. In the other mode, you can move. So you can go forward and backwards. But you can definitely see why it would be hard to recover this plane, so... You and I have seen a lot of weird comments, honestly. Sometimes I get roped into reading the comments, and I'm just like, oh my god, come on, guys. Accidents happen. Right in front of us again. So we'll make our way back there and do a nice little landing. So we did fly around about 2 miles out around the entire base. As you can see, there would be a lot of room for a plane to go down, and would be pretty, especially if it exploded into a bunch of pieces. You didn't see the original explosion, it might be hard to find. And that was South Carolina, it's more humid and it's a little bit more wet too, so it's probably not going to start a fire on the ground like it would where I live in California. If the plane went down, it would